Our advanced look on retail sales for November, up 2/10, better than the up 1/10 many were expecting, and a really nice revision to last look, up 0.8, now stands at up 1.1. Take out autos, still holding, up 2/10 as expected. We gained 3/10 in the rearview mirror from 7/10, the up 1% on our last look. Take out autos and gas, you end up with a better number, up 0.5, and also more than doubled our last look from 0.3 to 0.7. The control number, buckle up, this is a biggie. The control number inputted in other data points upstream, up 9/10. We're expecting a number up 4/10. And our last look moved from 0.3 to 0.7. So this is very compelling data. I mean, obviously it could always be stronger. Maybe X autos could have been a little bit better, but it was as expected. But that control number is pretty good number. The dollar index having a stellar day, actually. If we were to close right here in the dollar index, it would be a fresh new high going back to the summer of 2017. You mentioned China. There's nervousness in the leveraged loan markets. And of course, we're looking at a pre-equity opening that doesn't look great. We are down 3 basis points on 10s on the day. We're up 3 basis points on the week. Becky, back to you.
All right, Rick, thank you very much. Have a great weekend, all right?
You too. Thank you.
Okay, see you later. Steve Liesman is here. He has more on the numbers. And Steve, what jumps out at you?
This is a good number. I mean, what Rick correctly points to the control group, and I was primed for a good number, and I'm excited to see it. And I'll tell you why, because I think the market's gotten ahead of itself in counting on the downturn and the slowdown next year. I think there's probably going to be a slowdown. It just seems like the market is predicting disaster. And I think all the indicators you would look at point to a strong consumer for not only our holidays survey, but, you know, employment and wages, all those things that you look at that would tell you that the consumer is going to be pretty strong. They're doing pretty well, and I like that.
Consumer's doing well, but I will tell you, we had Jerry Storch on earlier today.
I heard that. And you guys did not commit suicide after talking.
No, but his point is, look, it's going to be a good holiday season no matter what. We just don't know if it's going to be a great holiday season, and there has been this lull that I guess you see every time. It's a longer calendar this time around because Thanksgiving was so early, 33 days.
Profitable holiday season.
Profitable, right, if you're looking from the stock's perspective. But if you're using this as an economic indicator of the consumer, that's one thing. If you're looking at retail stocks.
Things are cheaper, but they're not making as much money.
This is terrible, but I don't really care, right? From an economics point of view, you want to know what people are spending.
Right, but
I mean, you guys will do the stocks, I do the other stuff.
But here's what
talk about.
I'm the janitor, I'm cleaning the toilets out here. You guys are running the business.
Well, that's true.
But you know, I'm just telling you.
Good, then we're back to 4 hikes next year.
Well, that's the thing.
So
I also think the market's got.
You can't give me anything.
No, because you're not doing the right assessment.
No, but think about it. It's all bad news now.
No, it's not all bad news.
Well, if the retail sales are really above expectations, then
Powell
can go back to
false
neutral.
Oh, my God. He can go back. It's not 4 hikes, but not zero.
But
not zero, which is what the market's thinking about. You can't have. You're like a guy, Joe. You want to eat the broccoli. You want to not eat your broccoli, but you still want mom to serve dessert.
Yeah, that's like what we all are. Let me ask you one more question.
Okay.
He said something that really struck me as something I hadn't thought about much before. You know how we always talk about retail sales. There's not any inflation there, and that's because goods have been made in China and other places, and they're so cheap, so you never see prices go up on so many of these things, and the advances we've made in electronics. He said he thinks the reason that you're not seeing more inflation is because of the internet and differences in competition and ways
they're
coming through.
Absolutely. It's part of the change dynamic. And I think you guys talk about it all the time. Joe likes to emphasize is that you're making monetary policy according to old rules in a new world thing. But can I talk quickly about online? There's one other aspect from our survey yesterday we didn't talk about. And this is this notion, get ready to throw stuff at me. You like to do it every morning. Have online sales peaked? And I want to show you our survey data, okay? We ask people, what are the one or two major places where you do your shopping, okay? So take a look at the first graphic here. I'm hoping you have it. And look, online is the far away winner, okay? 44%. What you don't see in that chart is that that's the same as last year, that 44%. There's been, after meteoric rise, so what I did is I indexed that 2012 to 100, and I compared online with everybody else in the next chart.
Okay.
And now take a look at what's happened to the growth. It kind of flattened out. Now, it's flattened out before, and you can see, so I'm wondering if the bricks and mortar stores have found, there's one other chart which we ask people a second kind of follow-up question. Do you do a lot of shopping online or a little shopping? And the next one shows that the a little shopping, it's now even. The people who do a little bit of shopping or none online, people who do a lot is now even in terms of 41-41. So, okay, we've had it flatten out before and then it's run up. I have 2 points I'd like
who's
to say.
Who's doing less shopping online?
Yeah.
It's just not less. Just do you do a lot? Or do you do a little or do you do a lot? That's really the two groups we have in it.
Do I do a lot or all?
Or all, or a lot.
Fine, yeah.
But anyway, dollar value, it's not units again.
It's not, right? It's not. Okay. Here's my question for all of you.
Okay.
Have the bricks and mortar stores or your attitude towards them changed to the point? If you go into Best Buy to buy a TV,
right?
Do you think the price is cheaper online anymore?
No. And I don't care. If I actually make the trip, for me, it's convenience. If I actually make the trip to the store, I'm walking out with it.
So
I'm not making the trip to the store.
This is why I wonder if this is a way that the, and this is from Courtney Reagan, our retail. Okay. When I showed her this data, she was skeptical. I'm skeptical of it because it's only 1 year trend. But if they have stopped this idea that I can definitely get a cheaper price online, then maybe they've found a way to
get,
even
to
things
find
out.
I think they're getting
killing
closer
their margins in the meantime.
Right.
Steve, one more thing here. I think that argues against that data.
Please.
That is, the number of store closures has never been higher, and it's going to continue on. In other words, you can't go to the same number of stores that you once did in terms of bricks and mortar. That drives you to online.
True.
So it's hard to believe with that data, it's going to slow down.
So you think we come back next year, we only do that particular survey once a year, and it's going to be higher still.
I bet that way.
I will say there's also a lot of talk that the retailers, the bricks and mortar stores, are just on the edge of implementing in-store type technologies that are enhancing or increasing the in-store experience.